Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Double A Lectures. I am Dr. Saurav Mani Tripathi and the topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines, Constructional Features. After completion of this short lecture, you may be able to explore the constructional details of a practical DC machine. It is well known to all of us that any DC machine can be operated either as a generator or as a motor. So the construction of a DC generator and that of a DC motor are essentially the same. As far as the constructional details are concerned, the DC machines have three key components, no matter whether it would be used as a generator or as a motor. These three key components are the magnetic field system, the armature, and the commutator along with brushes. The function of the magnetic field system is to produce the effective and uniform main field flux within which the armature rotates. It is usually the stationary part of the DC machine. On the other hand, the rotating part of the DC machine is known as armature. The leads from the armature coils are connected to the commutator segments, whereas the brushes are the means by which the current is collected from or conducted to the armature coils via commutator. Unlike the elementary DC machine, the practical construction of a DC machine is quite different. So, let us understand the constructional features of a practical DC machine. So, this is a picture depicting the stationary part of a practical DC machine. In this picture, this component is the outer frame of the DC machine, known as yoke. And it is essentially made of solid cast steel or rolled steel. In reality, the yoke not only provides a protective cover to the DC machine, but also provides a return path for the magnetic flux produced by the main poles. This component is called main pole, which is essentially an electromagnetic pole. Now, the first question is, why we use electromagnetic poles in practical DC machines instead of using permanent magnetic poles? In reality, when the electromagnetic poles are used, a better control over field strength is possible by controlling the current flow through the field winding. You may easily notice that the number of main poles is even, and these main poles are bolted on the yoke of the machine. The main pole has two parts, which pole core and pole shoe. The pole core may either be a solid piece of cast steel or made of laminations of sheet steel. Each pole core has a pole shoe, which is also laminated in order to reduce the eddy current losses and has the curved surface to support the field coils. In reality, the pole shoe not only spreads out the flux uniformly in the air gap, but also increases the cross-sectional area of the magnetic circuit in order to reduce the reluctance of the magnetic path. There may be one or more field coils placed over each pole core. These field coils are connected in series with one another in such a manner that alternate north and south poles could be produced in the direction of the rotation when the current flows through the field coils. Besides main poles, sometimes the DC machines may also be provided with interpoles. Practically, there may be as many interpoles as the number of main poles. However, in small DC machines, the interpoles are rarely used. The interpoles are placed midway between the main poles. The interpoles are also bolted on the same yoke, and constructionally, they may either be solid or laminated, just like the main poles. It is worth notable that the interpoles essentially help in reducing the problem of sparking at the commutator under loading conditions. This is why they are sometimes referred to as commutating poles or comp poles. The rotating part of the DC machine is called armature, which essentially consists of a shaft upon which a cylindrical shaped armature core is mounted. This is a picture depicting the armature of a large DC machine. However, for the sake of more clear illustration of the armature construction, we have another picture of the same used for a small DC machine. As can be seen in this picture, several circular sheet steel discs or laminations are used to build a cylindrical shaped armature core. The armature core has a number of slots, or you may say grooves, on its outer periphery so as to place the conductors of the armature coils. The leads from the armature coils are connected to the commutators, which are made of copper segments and are insulated from each other by a thin layer of mica. The commutator segments are also mounted on the same shaft. In addition, it must be noted that the number of commutator segments is essentially equal to the number of armature coils. The brushes are the means by which the current is collected from or conducted to the armature coils via commutator. The brushes are usually made of carbon or graphite and are in the shape of rectangular bar. Each brush is supported by a metal holder known as brush holder. A spring is usually used to adjust the pressure exerted on the commutator segments by each brush through respective brush holder in order to avoid excessive wear of both the brush as well as the commutator, and also to ensure the proper electrical connection between the rotating commutator and the external circuit. It is also worth mentioning that an imperfect contact between the commutator and brushes due to an inadequate pressure exerted on the commutator segments by the brush may certainly lead to the sparking. Now, this is a schematic diagram of a DC machine illustrating various parts of the DC machine. In this diagram, you may easily find the yoke, the main pole core, the pole shoe, the commutating pole or interpole, the armature core, the armature winding, the field windings, the commutating field winding, the compensating winding, and after all, the commutator and brushes. Besides these, there exists a gap between the pole and armature core, which is termed as air gap. Although the air gap does provide high reluctance path to the working magnetic flux, it is essentially a mechanical requirement in order to ensure frictionless rotation of the armature. Hence, it is always desirable to make the air gap as short as possible. Moreover, the rotating parts of the DC machine are supported by the bearings so as to allow uniform and low friction rotation of the armature shaft. This is all about the constructional features of the DC machines. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.